Why can't you see the stars in space? 5 reasons. Since space agencies began sending astronauts into space, we've been seeing stunning photos of Earth, the Moon, and the International Space Station. However, we often notice that the images do not include the stars. Why? Shouldn't they look even brighter? Why don't photos taken in space include stars? Let's find out. Photographs taken from space can be disconcerting for many who expect to see the starry space that we fall in love with on Earth. Let's analyze the 5 most important factors contributing to missing stars in space photographs and the technological implications that this involves. 1. Intense sunlight. The main factor that prevents the stars from being seen in space photographs is intense sunlight. When the camera is set up to capture the details of the foreground object, sunlight entering the camera can saturate the sensor and make the image appear too bright. This means that the fainter stars are not visible. To capture the stars in space, the camera must be set up much differently than it is set up to take pictures of closer objects. The camera must have a wider aperture and a longer exposure time to capture the starlight, but consequently, the object in the foreground will be excessively illuminated and its details will not be visible. 2. Shutter speed. Shutter speed is also an essential factor that affects your camera's ability to capture the stars. In most space photography, a fast shutter speed is used to prevent the image's blurring due to the spacecraft's movement. However, this means the camera does not have enough time to capture enough starlight. To get a clear image of the stars, the shutter speed should be slower, but consequently, the image would have more noise, i.e. more movement, and therefore more imperfections that would make the main object look blurry. 3. ISO. The ISO is the camera's sensor's sensitivity to light. The camera should be set to low ISO sensitivity when taking pictures from space to capture starlight effectively. However, when photographing a closer object, such as the Earth or the Moon, the ISO sensitivity can be set higher to capture more detail, which also causes dimmer lights, such as stars, to be missed. 4. Focal length. Focal length is also essential to consider when taking space photos. Most cameras in space have wide-angle lenses to capture a comprehensive view of space. However, this means that the stars appear smaller in the image. A longer focal length is required to get a more detailed image of the stars. 5. Image processing. Another critical factor affecting space photos' ability to show stars is image processing. Images captured by space cameras are typically processed to increase the contrast and clarity of foreground objects. However, this can have the side effect of dimming the fainter stars. Therefore, astrophotographers must be careful when processing images so as to not lose detail in the stars. Despite these factors, there are some space photographs in which stars are visible. These images are taken under special conditions, such as during spacecraft shutdown maneuvers, when a slower shutter speed and wider aperture are used. Also, stars may be more visible in photographs taken from the night side of Earth, where sunlight does not interfere with star capture. Dealing with the lack of stars in space photographs is challenging for astrophotographers, as stars are an essential part of the landscape. To overcome this challenge, astrophotographers use special image processing techniques to improve the visibility of the stars. This includes adjusting image exposure and ISO sensitivity and applying stacking techniques to combine multiple images and increase star clarity. Additionally, astrophotographers use specialized equipment to capture images of stars from space. This equipment includes special telescopes and cameras designed to capture high-quality images of celestial objects. Some of these kits also include special filters that remove unwanted light and improve the visibility of stars. Technological implications. Taking pictures of stars from space presents technical challenges and critical technological implications. To take high-quality pictures of stars, you need a space camera capable of capturing the light from long-range, faint stars. In addition, the camera must be able to handle the intense radiation of space and withstand the extreme conditions of the space environment. Space agencies are developing increasingly advanced and rugged space cameras to overcome these challenges. These cameras use innovative technology, such as sensitive image sensors, to capture high-quality images of celestial objects. They also use advanced materials and cooling systems to protect the camera from the harmful effects of the space environment. Images from the Apollo missions. One of the things that some conspiracy theories about the moon landings of the Apollo missions are based on is that no stars appear in the photographs taken. Although this phenomenon has already been repeatedly explained, there is something worth noting about the cameras. The cameras used by the astronauts on the Apollo missions were Hasselblad 500EL cameras equipped with Zeiss lenses, Biogon 60mm and 80mm focal length. These medium format cameras use 70mm photographic film, allowing them to take high quality images with excellent resolution and detail. These cameras were not designed to capture background stars, as they were optimized for photographing nearby objects and the lunar surface. Although, during the Apollo missions, astronauts used cameras with manual settings, which allowed them to control the exposure of the images. The astronauts never adjusted the cameras to be able to capture the stars, since their priority was to capture the activity that were done on the moon. In addition, were large and robust, lined with insulators so they could function on an atmosphere less surface like the moon. These cameras did not have LED screens like modern cameras and did not have a lens to observe what they were photographing. In reality, the astronauts could not see the results of the photos until they reached Earth and the tapes were revealed. Since to take the photos, the astronauts placed the camera at chest level and took the picture blindly, hoping that it would turn out well. That is why all the astronauts practice a lot to know which position and height to place the cameras to take the photos, without having to see what they were photographing on a screen or a lens. The lack of stars in moon photographs is due to the proper exposure needed to capture the moon's surface, which is much brighter than the stars. The cameras needed to be set to a specific shutter speed and aperture to get a well-exposed image of the lunar surface. These settings were unsuitable for capturing background starlight, requiring short exposures and small apertures that limited the light entering the camera. Also, the cameras used by the astronauts did not have the sensitivity necessary to capture stars in the background. These cameras were designed to operate in extreme environments of temperature, vacuum, and radiation, and could not be equipped with digital sensors like modern cameras. The light sensing technology in the photographic film used at the time was not sensitive enough to capture background stars, which contributed to the lack of stars in photographs of the moon taken by NASA astronauts. The cameras used by astronauts on the Apollo missions were not designed to capture background stars due to the exposure and sensitivity needed to capture the lunar surface and nearby objects in space. Digital cameras today are much more technologically advanced than back then, and capturing starlight and foreground objects is much easier. But half a century ago, that was impossible. Never been a priority. The last and probably the most crucial reason why most space agency photographs do not show the stars is that the objective of the photographs has never been to capture the stars. Space telescopes and space exploration probes carry various scientific instruments and tools to study space, but these tools have particular purposes and only serve particular tasks. For example, most space probes carry cameras to photograph planets, comets, asteroids, and other objects in the solar system. These cameras are not only for visible light. They detect all spectrums of electromagnetic radiation, such as ultraviolet or infrared. These types of cameras are known as multispectral cameras. In the universe, there are very few objects that can be seen with the visible light detected by our eyes. Most objects in the universe are seen only with ultraviolet light, radio waves, or infrared light, which is why most probes are equipped to detect this type of radiation and not starlight in the visible light range. Space exploration probes and telescopes primarily aim to study the universe. It just so happens that the universe is seen primarily in radio waves, infrared light, and ultraviolet light. Few things can be studied with visible light. In addition, each gram is worth a lot in a space telescope or exploration probe, so all the capacity the spacecraft can carry with it is optimized to the maximum. It is equipped only with the instruments necessary to meet the mission's objectives, not an ounce more. That is why these expensive spacecraft are not equipped with state-of-the-art cameras, nor do they carry potent equipment like the ones used by professional photographers, because they are not necessary for the objectives of the missions. The best example of this is the James Webb Telescope. Have you ever wondered why there isn't a single photograph of the James Webb Telescope floating where it is? The reason is that James Webb does not carry a camera to take pictures of itself. Why? Because it's not necessary. What good would it do for scientists to take a picture of the James Webb Telescope floating in the vacuum of space it is currently located in? In addition to being useless, it is impossible since James Webb is entirely alone, and the only thing that illuminates it is the sun. So if you wanted to take a picture of it, you would have to had built an extendable arm that would go far enough off the telescope to take a photograph against the light. Can you imagine that? Spending so many resources, money, and time to take a selfie. That's not profitable, considering that each extra kilogram on the telescope costs NASA several million dollars. The same is the case with almost all spacecraft. Cameras that capture visible light are rarely mounted on them and therefore fail to capture images of the stars, since the cameras they carry have a completely different purpose. In short, no space agency finds it profitable to spend so much money to mount a camera on a spacecraft capable of photographing the stars to pander to the whims of a group of people who believe that humans have never been to space. Despite that, if there are many photographs and videos where it is possible to appreciate the stars, these are ones taken by the International Space Station astronauts. The ISS astronauts have had much more free time than the astronauts who went to the moon. Thanks to that, they have been able to manage and adapt different types of instruments in the cameras to be able to capture the light of the stars and even other objects. Despite technological limitations, space agencies continue to work hard to capture more accurate and detailed images of the universe around us. Their work inspires us to continue exploring space and to deepen our understanding of the mysteries of the universe. The lack of stars and photographs of Earth and the Moon and the International Space Station is an essential lesson about the limits of technology and the limitations of our perception. But it's also an opportunity to appreciate the beauty of what we can see and understand about the complexity of space exploration. Space photography invites us to reflect on our existence in this vast and beautiful universe. It reminds us that our curiosity and passion for discovering the unknown can lead us to develop technologies that help us see what is hidden in plain sight.